updating data using client-side object model. See, in the example we did before, we have only seen how we can fetch data, and that too selective data. Now I would like to have a program to update, let's say, web title. We want to submit from client to server. What is the procedure? So yes, first two lines will be same. We want to create the context object. Once we have the context, I would say context.load. What is that we want to load? The web property of the context. And that too we want to load very specifically only title of the web. And then I would say context.web.title is equal to from client side object model. But how is this updated? To update this, we need to write context.web.update. But update is not sufficient. What is important is, see, now I first make this as the startup. Program to update web title. And go to the browser, refresh, and we'll see that it's still the old title only, demo site. It's not updated. So what is the reason for not updating? Yes, even for making changes, we have to say execute query. Execute query is needed in all cases. Only then a trip will be made by browser to, I mean, by the client to server. Now refresh and we'll see the new title. So like this, any property of any object when changed, we have to do update on that object, and followed by that we have to say execute query, then only it would be updated, otherwise it would not be updated. It should be part of load and executed. Now next program I would like to take is how to create a list through code. So yes, class program to create list, static void main. Now to create a list, we need to have an object of list creation information. Basically that is the infrastructural object needed. So rather I'll copy this part. I'll explain you what is this program doing ultimately. Yes, so we have to first create is an object of list creation information. Now once we have the list creation information object, we have to specify the name of the list. Let us say project estimate is the name of the list, and then we have to specify the description, whatever, a list created using client object model, followed by that specify the type of the list, basically the list template. Here we are saying it is generic list. Remember, list template type is a enum and it has got all the templates available. All these are different templates. We are interested in generic list. This enum has to be casted to integer because template type is of type integer. On quick launch we want it to be visible. And finally the list is created using context.web.list.add. This is going to create a list, and the list gets created at the time of execute query. So yes, at this point of time we will see that the list is created in the backend, that is in SharePoint. But that list will have only one column by default, that is title. We would like to add more fields to that. Now to add fields to the list, you have to use list.fields.addField as XML. This is very similar to exactly what we did on server side object model. And this is the camel we have to specify for the field. So yes, the field here which I am specifying is a choice having a display type as category, and it is a drop down list. And then these are default value specification, development, test, documentation are the four types of category of estimation. And for each one of them, I would like to specify estimate number. So yes, schema XML, add to default view, add field options. Followed by this, see, these are fields created, added, but are they reflected yet? No, for this it has to be again executing a query. But before that, now we want to add items also. So for that we have to use list item creation information. Earlier it was list creation information, now it is list item creation information. And then for that list item, and for the list item, put the data, update. Second list item, same thing, same item creation information. Update. So what you have to note is item creation information is basically just a object needed here, but we are not anywhere directly making use of it. We just need that as a parameter to item dot list dot add item method. And finally, when you say execute query, fields will be added and items also will be inserted into the list. So program to create list. Let us make this as the start project now and run. Perfect. Now go to SharePoint site, refresh it, and we should see that there is a new list created, project estimates, and that should have title, category, estimate and three rows. So list creation information is the key, and list item creation information is the key here for creation of the lists and list items. Let us move to the next example, using camel to query list. Actually, we know this example in server object model. So very similar example. So I just copy all this code. We have certain things extra like include and all that stuff, which I have to explain you. So class program to query using camel. Paste it. So let us understand this quickly. So first we have the site URL. Create the context object, that is fine. Now we are getting the list by title, courses list, and from courses list I would like to get all courses whose duration is greater than 10. Courses list should get me all courses whose duration is greater than 10. So if we create a camel query object, and then we have to set the view XML. So in view XML, the query should be mentioned, and maximum row limit, here we have given 100. So maximum number of rows which we can fetch is 100. So at one place only we are specifying query as well as row limit in view XML is the single property of camel query. So yes, list dot get items, the camel query list item collection will come. Now once we have the list item collection, we have choice of getting all the items, or we can specify only certain specific columns which we want to fetch from the list. Now how do we specify only selected columns? We can say load, which is list item, that is good enough, this we understand. But after that, for every list item, we are saying items dot include title, duration, overview, fees. you have to understand is the syntax. The syntax is very special here. So yes, instead of getting all the items, and I mean, though we are getting all the items, instead of getting all the columns of all the items, we are specifically saying we want only these four columns: title, duration, overview, and fees, and then say execute query, and we can get the count followed by this. This is general list item of title, list of item of blah 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 story. So let us make this as the startup now. Run. Total number of items are 3, and all the 3 have duration 30, 60, 90. We can change it just for demonstration. Let's say 40. So we should get only 2 now. And try to exclude one. Let's say I cut duration and run this. But here we are trying to read the duration. So we should be getting exception. Property of field not initialized. It is very important. So basically, always we should strive to get only that data we are interested in, instead of getting all the data, because there would be large amount of data in every list item. We may not be interested in all that data. So what is important is, you should know include is always used in context of some collection. We have actually used include earlier also, here in this example include, where we were saying only title and item count property should be included. But these are direct properties of the list, whereas these are not direct properties of the list, and hence we had to write like this: duration, title, these are not direct properties of the list item. They are there for every list item, but they are indexed properties, and hence the syntax is little different. Though in this case, yeah, I could have actually written item dot title is also not there, so even that is not possible. Next, query large data, large amount of data if it is there. Say for example, a list have 10,000 records, 10,000 items. I may not be interested in fetching all the 10,000 items. I might be fetching only a particular page of items. So how do we get only a selected page of items? So I just again copy this. Into a new program I'll create. Program to query large list. Paste here. Okay, static void main. So yes, we have got the URL, context, get by title, demo. So I'm saying that we have a list by name demo, list creation information, and I'm inserting 100 items into the demo list. Item number 0. 0 is what? I. So this goes from 0 to 99. So 100 items are added. This is only for demo purpose. So what is the condition here? There should be a list by name demo already existing, and we have it. Not there. So let's create a new list. Add an app. Custom list. Demo. Okay. It's giving error. So it should be already there. Site contents. Demo. We can delete these old items. So we have a demo list, and that too also has, that has a title, and we would like to fetch all the items. Now after items are added, we want to now fetch one page of items. For this, obviously first we'll have to specify view, what fields we want to view, only title, row count 10 items at a time we would like to fetch. That is what is the meaning here. Row limit, so though we have 100, we don't want all 100, we want only 10 at a time. So how do we get that 10? So first we create here a list collection position which is by default null, and this null value will be added to the camel query list collection position. Camel query dot list collection position is by default null. In such case, list dot get items is going to get us first 10 items, and those first 10 items we actually get it here by executing the query. And after that, whatever is the new list position, I am again putting it in the item position so that it goes back and again it becomes the new value. And this we continue to do till we check that item position is again equal to null. So yes, item position will be incremented from null to 10, 11th, 11th to 21, 21 to 31 and so on, and that sometime will become null. Of course, just for demo I am putting paging info and also lines for one page at a time. So go to properties, large list, run. It's taking more than the required time. The URL is correct. Control C. Let's put a breakpoint. First, did the items get inserted here? We created a list by name demo. Okay, items are there. Good, items are there. So next time this at least we don't need. List item creation information is not needed. Now we framed a query. Position is null by default. Here we are printing. This is going to get us only 10 items. Why 10? Because row limit is 10. Let's put a breakpoint and run till there. And step into. Perfect. Query is executed. Now item position. Right now item position is null. But with this, item position now got initialized to something else. PID 23. Last item we fetched is 23. Go to next. Let's say till here. So all the items are now printed on the console window. Perfect. Go to next. Page info we have printed, and just say continue. Remove the breakpoint. Continue. Control F5. Yes. So one page at a time we have got it. Now let us say I want to get only item for one page. Maybe the page where PID is greater than 10 or something like that. So what we can do is here create a new object of list creation position, and in this we can say item position dot page info, and we have to set the value here. Now what should be the value? Earlier we have printed this, so let us go here. See, paged underscore true ampersand PID is equal to some number. So I'll say paged underscore true ampersand p underscore id is equal to some number, let's say 65. Now run. Oh, it's again getting me from first only. P underscore ID. Control F5. See, item number is 52, but of course PID is 65. To 75, 75 to 85, 85 to 95, 95 to 105, and so on. PID is basically ID of the item, list item, that we have to figure out. At that position, what is the ID, and then some logic has to be written extra. But yes, using this, we are able to get data of a given page rather than getting all the list item at a time. A very, very useful program. Finally, let us see the program for deleting client objects in for each loop. Now here there is a problem. You cannot iterate through the collection deleting the objects. See, this is one common mistake we would do. As we are iterating through the collection, we would try to delete the items in the object. That is not allowed. As soon as you delete the first object, it causes the iterator of the client object collection to malfunction. The iterator may throw an exception, or it may quietly finish but not visit all items in the collection. Instead, you must materialize the collection into the list using toList method, and then iterate through that list and delete the client object. That toList is the trick here. So yes, I go back to all, I copy this program now. We have written one program here to create large list, that is okay. Now I write a separate program. Program to delete items. Paste it. So you have the URL, client context, get by title, this is camel query. We are getting 100 items all at a time now. And these 100 items we would like to delete. So yes, we execute the camel query. We are saying load, and to get the list of all items, include only title. If you don't want all this, you can just say, because anyhow we are going to delete, we are just fetching the title. But even this is fine to keep it simple in this program. Even this is fine. I get all the list items. Now after I get the list items, let us say I do not write this toList. We are going through each item in the list, and that list item we'll say delete object, and finally execute query. Now run this. Now we have to change the startup object. So go to project, properties, program to delete items. Now run once again. Did the items get deleted? Verify. Go to the demo list and refresh, and we'll see that all the items are intact. Nothing is deleted. All are there. So how, what is that we should do? Just take this precaution of writing here dot toList. Now what dot toList does is, there itself it executes the query. Now once the query is executed here, we get all the items, and then one item at a time we are marking it as deleted, and all of them will finally get deleted here. So for delete item, you have to take care of this precaution. Now run this. Same. But the difference is, now if I go here and refresh, see, now we still have the items. the items are not deleted. Load, all items are loaded. We are saying list item, just put a breakpoint here, debug. It's not coming here at all. Okay, I put a condition here. Title type is equal to value text. I'll remove this where condition. I don't want to put the where condition. Now run this. It's just trying to delete all the 100 items from the list. Verify. Perfect. All the items got deleted. But when this to list is not there, because we do not have, let's add items otherwise. One, two. And now go back and run the same program once again, and we get the exception. So the to list is very, very important, because when you do not write to list, the query will execute inside the for loop, and there you're not supposed to delete the item. So this is a precaution you have to take care of whenever you are deleting the items in loop. If you're not deleting the items in loop, this problem will not come. So yes, all the programs are given here. I would suggest you try all of them. So we have seen how to create a list, how to create a field in the list, how to create list items, how to get the list items. All the basic operations what we routinely perform, we have completed in this. Of course, there is always a scope for learning more on SharePoint object model. But what is your learning curve? The learning curve will continue with learning more classes and learning their properties. But basic architecture is same. We have to load, execute, update, execute. That's it. This is what you have to continue doing for the rest of the client-side object model learning curve. Thank you.